Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaley Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on subject air compressor. In this lecture, we are going to discuss the multi-stage compression with intercooling. This is lecture number 3 on the air compressor. In the earlier two lectures, we discussed the working of single-stage reciprocating compressor. And we derived the work done for a single stage reciprocating compressor with a different compression process. And we discussed the efficiency, isothermal efficiency, adiabatic efficiency, and the volumetric efficiency. We derived the expression for volumetric efficiency of a single stage reciprocating compressor. Now we discussed the multi-stage compression with perfect intercooling. And the learning outcome to the students at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to explain the working of two-stage reciprocating compressor and derive the work done equation for the two-stage reciprocating compressor. The compressing air in more than one stage, that is one cylinder, is called as multi-stage compression. Normally, in a single-stage compressor, the maximum pressure is possible, maybe at the maximum of 5. So the outlet pressure, the pressure at the delivery of the cylinder, engine, compressor will be 5 times the atmospheric pressure. When we want a higher pressure ratio, or when we want the air at a higher pressure for some specific applications, we have to go for multi-stage compression. So the multi-stage compression is used when the pressure ratio is higher than 8 to 10. So the pressure ratio means the delivery pressure divided by the suction pressure or the inlet pressure of the compressor. For a higher pressure ratio, when you use the single stage compressor, so the overall size of the compressor will increase and the work input to the compression also will be very high, because during the compression process, the air is getting heated because of the compression process. So the hot air will consume more amount of work for compression. So for higher pressure ratio, necessarily we have to go for a multi-stage compressor. The various advantages of multi-stage compressor. The work done per kg of air is reduced in multi-stage compression with the intercooling as compared to the single-stage compression for the same delivery pressure. So that is what I told. So we have to use multi-stage compression to reduce the work done per kg of the air. So the volumetric efficiency is higher for the given pressure ratio in the multi-stage compression. The mechanical balancing is better. So because we have two-stage compressor, normally two-stage compressor you may find in the automobile repair shop that is used for compressing, and laboratory also we have the two-stage compressor, reciprocating compressor, for conducting the test to calculate various parameters. It reduces the leakage losses considerably. So the pressure rise per cylinder will be less. So that is why the leakage losses are reducing. The construction is lighter due to the lower pressure per stage. So the overall size and weight of the material per cylinder will be less. It provides efficient lubrication, effective lubrication, because of lower temperature range. So the temperature rise across the inlet and the outlet of a single cylinder is less, so that the quality of the lubrication oil, lubricating oil, and the effective lubrication is possible in the case of multi-stage compression. And this is the diagrammatic representation of a two-stage reciprocating air compressor. So we have a low pressure cylinder and the high pressure cylinder. In between we have the intercooler. So this is intercooler, which is a heat exchanger which removes the heat energy from the air. The air is taken from the atmosphere. From the atmosphere, at the atmospheric condition, we take condition number 1. P1 is the pressure we call here, and T1 is the temperature. It enters the low pressure cylinder where it is getting compressed. So the compression takes place here, as we explained earlier in the previous lecture. So the piston is reciprocating, and the air is compressed to a higher pressure P2 and temperature T2. So here the temperature is T2. Now the air with the pressure P2 and temperature T2 enters the intercooler, which is a heat exchanger. So here we circulate water. So for a heavy duty application, we circulate some water and remove the heat energy. But in the case of lower capacity, the compressor used in the automobile shop, they are air-cooled heat exchanger. So there will be air cooling, so to reduce the temperature. Now the temperature is reduced to T3. So from T2, the temperature is reduced to T3, and across the heat exchanger, across the intercooler, the pressure remains same. There is no change in the pressure, but the temperature is reduced to T3, and for perfect intercooling, we assume T1 equal to T3. Now with the pressure P3 and temperature T3, the air enters the high pressure cylinder where it is further compressed, so and it is leaving with the pressure P4. So the inlet pressure is P1, outlet pressure is P4, and here P2 is the outlet pressure of the first cylinder or the low pressure cylinder, and P3 is the inlet pressure of the high pressure cylinder or the second cylinder, which is equal to P2. Now we have to calculate the work done. So the work done in a two-stage compression with the perfect intercooling. So we have to write the equation for work done. As we discussed in the single stage compressor, so the work done for the first compressor, low pressure compressor, N by N minus 1, the P1 V1 into P2 by P1 to the power N minus 1 by N minus 1. So P2 is the pressure at the outlet of the LP cylinder, P1 is the pressure at the inlet of the LP cylinder, plus N by N minus 1, P3 V3. So V3 is the condition of the air at the inlet of the high pressure cylinder, into P4 by P3 to the power N minus 1 by N minus 1. So P4 is the delivery pressure of the high pressure cylinder, and P3 is the suction pressure of the high pressure cylinder. Now we have this equation. I rewrite the equation again. W equal to N by N minus 1 MRT1. So P1 unit equal to MRT1 into P2 by P1 to the power N minus 1 by N minus 1, plus N by N minus 1 MRT3 into P4 by P3 to the power N minus 1 by N minus 1. For perfect intercooling, we know T1 equal to T3, and the equations are combined here. W equal to N by N minus 1 MRT1 into P2 by P1 to the power N minus 1 by N, plus P4 by P3 to the power N minus 1 by N minus 2. So combining the minus 1 and minus 1 equal minus 2. Now we take suction pressure equal to P1. So that is the pressure at the inlet of the compressor. Intermediate pressure, we said, across the intercooler, the temperature is reduced and the pressure remains constant. So we said P2 equal to P3. So the intermediate pressure is the outlet pressure of the first cylinder, that is equal to the inlet pressure of the second cylinder, which we call it as P2. And the delivery pressure is P3. Delivery pressure at the outlet pressure of the second compressor is P3. Now the equation is modified. So N by N minus 1 MRT1. So P2 by P1, there is no change. P4 is changed to P3 and P3 is changed to P2. So this is the inlet pressure. P4 is the outlet pressure. P3 is the inlet pressure. Now it is replaced by P3 by P2 to the power N minus 1 by N minus 1. Now we take the equation again. W equal to N by N minus 1 P1 V1 into P2 by P1 to the power N minus 1 by N, plus P3 by P2 to the power N minus 1 by N minus 2. Now we have to find out the condition for minimum work done. So look at the equation. N is the polytropic index, P1 is the suction pressure, V1 is the volume, and P3 is the intermediate pressure, P2 is the intermediate pressure, P3 is the delivery pressure, and P1 is the suction pressure. Now here, delivery pressure, suction pressure, they are fixed by the compressor design, and the volume of the cylinder is also fixed by the design. And the only parameter which can be controlled is P2, the intermediate pressure. So for minimum work done, we have to differentiate this equation with respect to P2 and equal to 0. Then we have to calculate the condition for P2 with respect to in terms of P1 and P3. So differentiating dW by dP2, so the value, this constant N by N minus 1, P1 V1 is constant. Differentiating, so we have P1 is constant, so 1 by P1 to the power N minus 1 by N, it is constant. Now we differentiate P2 to the power N minus 1 by N. So N minus 1 by N into P2 to the power N minus 1 by N minus 1, plus P3 is constant. So P3 to the power N minus 1 by N is constant, and we have to differentiate P2 to the power minus, so we take the p2 to the numerator, so this become p2 to the power minus n minus 1 by n. So minus of n minus 1 by n, p2 to the power minus n minus 1 by n, minus 1, and this equal to 0. When we equal to 0, this term n by n minus 1 p only 1, that is getting deleted. Now the value within the square bracket, that is equal to 0. We write again n by n minus 1 minus 1, 1 by p1 to the power n minus 1 by n into p2 to the power n minus 1 by n minus 1 minus. So here we have a minus sign. So this plus will become minus. So minus p3 to the power n minus 1 by n into n by n minus 1 by n into p2 to the power minus n minus 1 by n minus 1. And we take the two separate terms. So the we take the first term to the left side and the second term to the right side. So n by n minus 1, n minus 1 by n into 1 by p1 to the power n minus 1 by n into p2 to the power n minus 1 by n minus 1. I have not changed any of the parameter as it is. Equal to, I take the this term, second term to the right side. So p3 to the power n minus 1 by n minus 1 by n into p2 to the power minus n minus 1 by n minus 1. Now, n minus 1 by n minus 1 by n on both sides, it is getting cancelled. Now, what is left out? 1 by p1 n minus 1 by n into p2 to the power minus 1 by n, that is equal to p3 to the power n minus 1 by n into p2 to the power minus 2n plus 1 divided by n. So combining the simplifying the numerator, simplifying the power, and here again simplifying the power, so this becomes p2 to the power minus 1 by n and p2 to the power minus 2n plus 1 divided by n, and rearranging the terms. So we rearrange, we club the p2 terms on the left side and we club the p1 p3 terms on the right side. So left hand side I have p2 to the power minus 1 by n. I take the p2 term to the left side. So p2 to the power divided by p2 to the power minus 2n plus 1 by n, that is equal to p1 p3 to the power n minus 1 by n. Now we take the term in the denominator to the numerator. P2 to the power minus 1, minus 1 by n minus 1 minus 2n by n. So the right hand side is as it is, p1 p3 to the power n minus 1 by n. Now we combine p2 to the power 2 into n minus 1 by n. Now these n minus the power value n minus 1 by n and n minus 1 by n, n minus 1 by n, that is getting cancelled. So what is left out? P2 square equal to p1 p3, or p2 equal to square root of p1 p3. And this is the condition for minimum work input to a two stage compressor. So p2 is the intermediate pressure and the p1 is the suction pressure, p3 is the delivery pressure. So the intermediate pressure is equal to the square root of suction pressure and delivery pressure. That is the condition for minimum work input for a two stage reciprocating compressor. And substituting the value, so we take the original equation for work done, replace the p2 value. So n by n minus 1 into p1 v1. So p2 is replaced. Now the p2 is replaced by square root of p1 p3 divided by p1 to the power n minus 1 by n plus p3 by square root of p1 p3 to the power n minus 1 by n minus 2. So combining, this will be n by n minus 1 p1 v1, p3 by p1 to the power n minus 1 by 2n plus p3 by p1 to the power n minus 1 by 2n minus 1. So there are two terms, same values. So 2n by n minus 1 p1 v1, p3 by p1 to the power n minus 1 by 2n minus 1. So this is the work done for two stage compressor with the perfect intercooling. Now we have n number of stages. Now the stage pressure ratio, first stage pressure ratio p2 by p1, second stage pressure ratio p3 by p2, and the last stage pressure ratio pn plus 1 divided by pn. Now in that case, the work done for the n number of stages, the general expression is equal W equal to capital N small n divided by n minus 1 into p1 v1 into pn plus 1 by p1 to the power n minus 1 by capital N small n minus 1, where capital N is the number of stages. So suppose if it is a two stage compressor, the capital N is replaced by 2. So we will get W equal 2N by N minus 1 P1 U1 divided by P, 2 plus 1 is 3, P3 by P1 to the power N minus 1 by 2N minus 1. That is the answer. That is the work done for a two stage reciprocating compressor. So we stop here. We calculate, we have some reflection spot. We have to answer the question based on our understanding of the discussion in the previous 15 minutes. Consider a two stage reciprocating compressor with the perfect intercooler operating at the best intermediate pressure. The air enters the low pressure cylinder at 1 bar 27 degrees Celsius and leaves the high pressure cylinder at 9 bar. Assuming the index of compression and the expansion in each stage is 1.4 and that of air R equal to 287 joules per kilogram Kelvin and the work done in the high pressure cylinder. Work done in the high pressure cylinder that we have to calculate. So only in the high pressure, not for the entire compressor, it is only for the high pressure cylinder. So use the expression from the discussion and calculate if your answer is 222 kilojoules and you are correct. And the clearance volume of a reciprocating compressor is 100 milliliter and the volume of the cylinder at the bottom dead center is 1 liter. The clearance ratio of the compressor is 1 by 11, 1 by 10 and 1 by 9 and 1 by 12. So the clearance volume we have to calculate. The answer is 1 by 10. I will show the answer is 1 by 10. You calculate. So clearance volume of the reciprocating compressor is 100 milliliter. So VC equal to 100 milliliter. Volume of the cylinder at the bottom dead center. VC plus VS equal to 1 liter. So we have to calculate it is 1 by 10. Which of the following statement does not apply to volumetric efficiency of the reciprocating air compressor? So it decreases with the increase in inlet temperature. It increases with the decrease in pressure ratio, it increases with the decrease in clearance ratio, it decreases with the increase in clearance to stroke ratio. The answer is, it decreases with the increase in clearance to the stroke ratio. And these are all the questions from gate examination. So you better prepare from the, listen to the video lectures and try to answer to the questions. In a single acting two-stage reciprocating compressor with the complete intercooling delivers air at 16 bar. Assuming an intake state 1 bar and 50 degrees Celsius, the pressure ratio per stage. So we define the pressure ratio, first stage, second stage. So we have P2 equal to square root of P1, P3. Then we have to calculate pressure ratio per stage. P2 by P1 you have to calculate. So the answer is 4. So we stop here. So these are all the textbooks I publish in mechanical engineering and I upload the video lectures in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning. And thank you. We'll meet again in another video lecture on the air compressor.